Hello and welcome to another update video about AVAX Avalanche. It recently was announced that the stablecoin USDC is launching on Avalanche. I think that has had this major push, or that led to this major push. My last video on Avalanche did a couple of days ago. We were just going higher here, and I told you about a trade setup, a possible trade setup. Again, never financial advice, but in my view, as I said back then, I would anticipate further price increases. We were here at $110. What I did tell you back then, just so that you understand my thought process a little more, when we were up here, I did say I wouldn't go in now personally because we were overbought on the hourly. I would wait for a small retracement, possibly down to $100, and see if the $100 hold, and then possibly in there for a long position. And that happened. So we did, you can see actually the RSI here on the hourly. It brought the RSI down. We retested the $100 successfully. As I said in that video, it would have been a good long entry with a stop loss set, you know, as a trader, possibly below one of these EMAs here, possibly below $95. That's what I said, but that is all depending on personal risk, the risk profile and whatever you're comfortable with. But that is what I would have done. Didn't do it. Because you can't just be in everything, you know, I focus on a few cryptos generally. But yeah, that would just to really give you an idea here. And I know a lot of people are interested in Avalanche at the moment. I remember when I made one of my previous videos, and we were just up here, after I told you that this would be my crypto for November, or one of my top three cryptos for November. And I did tell you that end of October, and since then we've made it 2.5x. I then sold, I think, 50% of my portfolio at $135, I think, or was it 125? I can't remember. It was somewhere in this region. It was definitely worth doing up here. I then reinvested in other cryptos. But yeah, this would have been a good long entry as well, just for you, just sort of as a learning as well, what can happen, you know, what you can do. This was very, very strong here. This strong move to the upside definitely doesn't look corrective. It looks impulsive to the upside. Could set us up for further continuation to the upside, and that is when you have a clear support level like here on the FIPS. This is ideal then to set basically stop losses and go in long. What is also advisable generally or recommended is when you have a crypto that on the hourly might be overbought, then you just wait for the retracement. But where you're not overbought yet on the longer term timeframes, for example, here on the daily, we're not overbought yet. So it might still be worth, if you believe in AVAX, you know, and I can't give you financial advice, but for me, I mean, I believe in AVAX, and anybody who, but I'm already invested in AVAX anyway, but anybody who is not invested or whatever, or would like to add to the position, I think it might be potentially worth getting in there or considering it, because we've just had this bullish crossover on the daily, on the MACD. I did tell you about that. Before it happened here, I think in the last few days, when my last video, I told you that a bullish crossover is going to come here for them on the MACD, which might be a buy signal. So that worked out. Bullish here in the bullish range on the RSI as well, on the daily. And we're not overbought yet. I know people will ask, you know, is it too late to go in when we're overbought on the daily? We're not yet. So possibly using a stop loss, I think that would be very important, and you know, especially as you are, it all depends. Again, if you're in there for the long run, you probably don't need a stop loss, you know, but if you are frustrated if the price then goes down, you probably need a stop loss, because then you would just do trading. And if you do trading and you get in a level like this here, where we already had quite a bit of a move to the upside here, I mean, this is already like 50% up in a few days. Without using that, without a stop loss, I think is quite risky. But as I said, on the daily, we are not overbought yet. So we actually have quite a bit of space. Possibly a move to $126 might be possible. If we break that, we could even go to a new all-time high. Yeah? So Avalanche looks quite strong overall here compared to some other cryptos, and a clearly impulsive move here to the upside. Only a few red candles overall, a lot of green candles. And we didn't even build that low that I thought we would do. So maybe we're going to come into that if we can't push higher here. But that's why I recommend using a stop loss. And it's looking interesting, looking strong. That would have worked out here, the trade setup that I talked about in my last video. And I think especially with the stablecoin launching on Avalanche, I mean, we already made a new all-time high without these news, and now we're just pumping because of that. I mean, that's huge news. That will definitely benefit the project. So yeah, I think we could be setting up for further continuation here. Not overbought on the daily yet. Yes, overbought on the 4 hours, so there might be a smaller retracement coming, a bit like what we had here. But overall, it's looking still very interesting. Avalanche, I think. Good crypto anyway. Great project. Not just the standard Solana competitor, I think. I think Avalanche is something really, really big that could also, really redefine DeFi and generally, you know, blockchain. It's a great project and very, very popular, and it's just amazing. So that's why I am invested, and I started talking about it when we were here at $50. So hopefully you liked the update. If you did, please smash the like button and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye.